You have mastered the integration of tracing and runtime evaluation in your project? Great. Let's bring that to an even higher level and fully automate it. Hello, my name is Svenja and I'm a working student in the runtime analysis team for Microsoft Classic projects at Vector. In this video, I want to show you how you can automate the workflow from generating your project in the DaVinci Configurator up to a fully evaluated trace report in the TA tool suite via just one click. After this video, you can use the trace automation bundle to improve your workflow and fully automate your own project. For a better understanding of the tracing workflow, let's have a look at the schematic. The trace automation is separated into different modules in the form of lightweight script files. The script files are used to trigger and execute the steps of the tracing workflow. Let's have a look at the contents. The start automation batch file is the heart of the automation process. It triggers the steps of the workflow to be executed after another. The process can either be started manually or as an external generation step in the DaVinci Configurator. I will show this in a later step. Start automation batch file then starts the build process of the project by using the usual compiling process defined in the make support. After the successful compilation, the start Lauterbach automation batch file is called. It uses trace32 to flash the project and record a trace. Finally, the TA tool suite automation is called. The script imports the recorded trace into a predefined project and evaluates it. When the process has finished, all windows will be closed, so that sequential calls of the workflow will not be blocked by each other. Before we have a look at the integration, please note that the Trace Automation Bundle is a one-click automation for an already working build and tracing workflow. The integration will not fix any issues related to the configuration or setup. Now to the integration of the Automation Bundle. For this, I am using a demonstrator project for an Aurix TriCore TC397XE that is connected to a power debug from Lauterbach. Also, an additional combi probe is connected, which will be used for the tracing. When using the trace automation bundle, we want to make sure that Canoe stays active and running in the background, so that during the tracing, we can actually see some communication on the canvas. We will not make any changes to its configuration. The first step is to add the Vector Trace Automation Bundle to our project. I have already downloaded and extracted it, so I can just drag and drop it here. You can find the information on where to download the Trace Automation Bundle in the documentation of the Timing Bundle or on our website at vector.com. Now that we have added the Vector Trace Automation Bundle to our project, we can go on with the next step. For the second step, we want to adapt the paths that are defined in the Start Automation batch file to match our local paths. For that, you can just open the Start Automation batch file in a text editor. As you can see, most of the paths are defined relative to your project, but be sure that these are correct as well. The last step is to create a project in the TA tool suite so the recorded traces can be evaluated. For that, we just open the TA tool suite and add another project to it. The name of the project is defined in the Start Automation batch file. In this case, it's just called Automation Project. You can actually name the automation project however you want, but be sure to change the name in the script files then. And just like that, we have integrated the Vector Trace Automation Bundle. Pretty easy, right? So let's try it out. For that, we can either use the command line and execute the batch file manually, or it is a one-click solution, we can double-click the Start Automation batch file and it will be executed as well. A console opens and you can see additional log output so that we can see which step is currently made. As you can see, the build process was skipped. This is because we did not make any changes to the files. Next up, Trace32 will be called. The project will be flashed and then a trace started. In this case, the whole process is really fast. We only trace for 3 seconds. It is configured in the Start Automation batch file. In the last step, the TA tool suite is called. We import the trace that we have just recorded. The workflow is executed and you can see the output in the console. As you can see, the windows close by themselves, so we can actually do sequential calls of the script. Under Trace Recordings, Automated Trace Recordings, we can see an MF4 file that was just created. This is the trace we recorded. As you can see, our automation project is still empty. We need to hit the refresh button so the imports are shown. There's not only an import added, but also the timestamp when it was recorded. The TA Tool Suite automation did not only import the trace, it also included an evaluation, so we can have a look at that. As you can see, the runnables and tasks are shown in both their current timestamps. Also, we have calculated the CPU load. As you can see, both cores are added. You can also adapt the evaluation configuration to show and evaluate what you want. Optionally, we can add the trace automation bundle to the DaVinci Configurator. The start automation batch file would then be executed as an external generation step after all the files will be generated. For that, we just open the DaVinci Configurator and go to the project settings. We want to add an external generation step. Hit the plus button and name it however you like. For the command line executable, select the start automation batch file. The working folder should be the bundle folder, that is, the vector trace automation folder. For the execution type, select serial. We want the start automation to be executed last, that is, after all the files have been generated. And that's almost it. Now we need to make sure that the trace automation is started last. So we need to go to the code generation and change the order. Great, that's it. Let's just try it out. For that, we want to generate the files. The start automation will be executed last. As you can see, the workflow is the same. We just started it in a different way. Regardless of the configuration as an external generation step, you can still double-click the start automation batch file and just execute it manually. So let's open our TA project and check if the import was correctly done. As you can see, everything worked fine. We now have two automated trace imports in our project. You can execute the trace automation workflow as often as you want. The imports will just be added to the project. You can also change the workflow so that, for example, the project is always the same and you have only one import. Feel free to try out and suit your project. I hope you enjoyed the demonstration of the Trace Automation Bundle. If you have any questions, feel free to write an email to support@vector.com or have a look in the technical documentation. Thank you for watching and have fun tracing.